is after I'd come to Bell Labs and set up an office and, you know, walking around as the most junior member of all of Bell Laboratories for 3 or 4 days, in my inbox came a package. And the package was maybe 8-10 inches long and about 1.5 inches square. And on the outside it said, "Danger, live alligator." I opened it up, eager to see what it was. And it was a live alligator. Well, in those days, early days, I spent more time at work than at home. So I set up an alligator home in my office. I got a 2-inch deep Pyrex dish, put it in my recessed window that had a heater in the bottom of it, filled it with water, and dumped the alligator in. It seemed to like it, liked the water very much. At first, I had to force feed the alligator because it just wouldn't eat. And so I'd take some fish and shove it down his throat and keep pushing until it either bit me or it swallowed the fish. The alligator got bigger and bigger and became eager to eat. And anything that would come over the lip of its dish would get bit because it was food. You know, it's the definition of food if it came over the edge. I went to the grocery store and got the cheapest fish I could find. I think it was tripe. And you could get about 500 pounds of it for $1.25. And I would take it into my office every day, and I would throw a chunk of this fish, over the edge of this thing. And this alligator would stay in the bottom of the water with just the eyeballs sticking up. And it would jump out, snap this thing, and it would make a loud snapping noise. It was very serious teeth. And then splash down in the water and there'd be nothing but the eyeballs. It was just that fast.
Thank you.